Berkeley School of Comedy. We're doing this. There's traffic out here. Nobody cares. We're going to stay until the night is over. I want to thank you guys for coming out. Follow me at Cinder Live and, of course, LASchoolOfComedy.com. I'm drowning.
Please welcome Sunda Krunquist.
I really get off on seeing people develop, and I have to tell you something. This next guy coming to the stage is no exception. He has one of the biggest podcasts right now that's going on iHeartRadio, and he's here for my pleasure, okay? Not your pleasure, my pleasure. The one and only, Bob Dean!
You'll do anything for me. Who run the world? Girls, girls. Who run the world?
Man, some great comics tonight, huh? Give it up for everybody. People say to me, Bob Dean, what do you do? I say, I'm a comedian and an actor. And they're like, oh, so you're a waiter. I'm like, please, what nerve, a waiter? Fuck you, I'm a bartender. I've been a bartender for 36 years. And let me tell you something, I am not there to charge your fucking phone. Ah, a lot of people out there asking all the time, right? I've worked in every place from five-star dining to Miami nightclubs to where they'll shoot you over a pool cue. Most people are pretty cool. I get fired every 3 years because of my attitude. It's always something like this. A guy comes over to the bar and he goes, I want a Belvedere martini straight up with blue cheese olives and shake it violently. And I'm like, yeah, like your baby. Come on, that was a good one. People in bars, generally people, it's like this. They walk through the door. It's hot in here. It's cold in here. The valet scratched my car. How many IPA beers do you have? I said, no salami. We want a dressing on the side. We're friends with the owner. And my favorite now is, we were overserved. Screw you. Overserved. You can't handle two martinis. It's not my problem. My motto is, if you have an airbag, have another. And I don't know, I'm old, yes, and this is your future, everybody, so get ready for it. But yeah, I remember when it was fun to drink and drive, you know. Come on, you guys, it's fun to drink and drive, a couple of pops, and now it's like all the fun out of a buzz drive, it sucks because now you have scooters and hoverboards and skateboarders. And if you have the unmitigated gall to be texting while you're riding any one of these three, watch out for me and my old Buick station wagon because I will run you down. And there are enough dents in it where nobody's going to be able to tell. But I digress. People in bars, I was overserved. You know, it's like this. Guys in bars are pretty easy. It's like a shot and a beer, martini, gin and tonic. Ladies, love you. But it's when you pick up that handcrafted cocktail menu, my left eye starts to twitch and I look at my watch and I'm like, crap, this bar is busy. And she's going to want something with cucumbers, mint, shaved ginger, and fresh pomegranate juice. And I'm going to make that drink. I'm going to shake it up. I'm going to strain it. You're going to take one sip and go, this is what I thought it was going to be. And I'm like, of course not. It's nauseating. Women in bars. White women in bars. I'd like to taste every one of your 26 wines by the glass because I've recently been to Napa. And I want something that's earthy, plummy, jammy, and cheap. Black women in bars. I want a strawberry pina colada. I want extra strawberries in that pina colada. I'm not going to pay for those extra strawberries, and I can't taste no alcohol in this. Persian women are just awful. No, at least in Beverly Hills. I got a good game in Beverly Hills. It's like this. You are the help. You read the wine list to me. I do not read. It is me. Asian women, they didn't never anything to drink. They just take pictures of the food. Right? This beautiful Hispanic woman sat down at my bar the other day. She started ordering in Spanish, and I was just over. I said, ma'am, I'm sorry, I don't speak Spanish, with an attitude. And she goes, you must be a racist. Me? A racist? Like, that's the fifth time last week somebody called me a racist. I'm a white man of privilege. Yeah, 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 so the media tells me. You know, I'm really offended by that because nobody has any idea how hard I had it growing up on the mean streets of Nashville, Tennessee. How hard? I had it hard, man. Our swimming pool did not have a diving board. It was rough, I tell ya. But seriously, I mean, what am I supposed to do to make myself a better guy if I'm a white man of privilege? I am a 13-year volunteer at the Braille Institute in Hollywood, California. Work, read with blind people. I foster animals in my home. I work very closely with the Pico Shelter on Pico. And right now, I've been fostering animals in my one-bedroom apartment for the last 10 years. I have 5 cats in a one-bedroom apartment right now, 3 of whom are black. Thank you. I am anything but a cracker racist, y'all. I am white. I'm Christian. I smoke cigarettes inside my home. I eat red meat. I don't speak a word of Spanish. I'm gay. I don't have a fake marijuana card, a fake handicap placard, or a fake fucking service dog in my purse, and I live in Los Angeles. I am the friggin' minority. You know, let the cat out of the bag. I'm gay. I'm a homosexual. I'm the kind of queer that hates fags. So fucking irritating, man. I'm a bear. And a bear is a big fat guy with body hair. And boy, do I have body hair. I don't shave nothing. Man, anybody out there manscape? Huh? Anybody? Guys at Manscaping, you think I'm fucking queer? True story. I used to be a member of the 24-Hour Fitness in Santa Monica. This was a couple years ago. I come out of the shower and these two nice-looking young men, one's over here, and they're obviously buddies. And one guy is shaving his nuts and the other guy is shaving his butt. And they're looking at themselves in the mirror and the one guy says, "Man, Tom Brady got screwed." And I was just toweling off and it just slipped out. I go, "Man, if you guys were at the 24-Hour Fitness in West Hollywood, you'd both be getting screwed right now." And they were like, "What?" Needless to say, that's when my membership terminated. But yeah, I'm a bear. You know, I like muscle cars and I drink a lot of beer. I'm a bear. Ow. I fell asleep at the pool last year and aliens made a crop circle in my back. When I'm in an intimate situation, my partner's favorite pillow talk is... Yeah, you know, Kiss, we got to get together and talk, girl, because I worked Miami nightclubs in the 80s before you were born, and let me tell you what, they really haven't changed a whole lot except for that Instagram shit. And seriously, we got to talk, because it is nutty, isn't it? God, I'm sorry, Kiss, I'm looking the wrong way because of my new glasses. If I'm a racist, I'm looking at the wrong beautiful black lady. I'm sorry. But yeah, you know, my nieces and nephews are so cute. They're like, "Uncle Bob, tell us about the 80s. Because I was a bartender in Miami in the 80s. And I'm like, you know what? Ronald Reagan was president and the movie Scarface was entirely accurate. Pot was pot. It was $40 for a big old ounce like this. And if you were lucky, you might score some Maui Wowie or Thai stick. Pink Peruvian cocaine was $20 a gram. And they shaved it right off the block. Like at the butcher. Delicatessen. And ecstasy was real, not this GHY. Crap that you kids are doing today. I don't do drugs anymore, but when I did, this was pot. It was like crap, I only have $67 in my checking account. I gotta wax my car, the rent's due next week. And cocaine was like, yeah, baby. I don't hear anybody outside. You hear anybody outside? You got any gin? You got any scotch? Can I smoke in here? But ecstasy was my favorite. It was like, man, it's been like half an hour, $20. What a ripoff, man. I want my fucking money. I love you, man. Let's dance. Yeah, Cindy, thank you very much for plugging my podcast. I'm very proud of it. And Cindy was the one that kicked my ass to do it. It's the Bob Dean Show. I hope you will subscribe on iTunes and follow me on iHeartRadio. You can watch it on YouTube. My 65th episode will be coming up next week. And about 6 months ago, I had on a psychic. Her name is Jennifer Diamond, and she's a stunning blonde from Boca Raton, and she's a very talented woman. And we're talking about this and that. She looks at me and goes, "Is your mother still with you?" And I said, "No, I lost her several years ago." And I said, "Why? Is she here?" And Jennifer started laughing, and she said, "Yes, she is, and she's very young, and she's very beautiful, and she's with you all the time." And my first thought was, crap, I'm never going to be able to jerk off again! It's my time. My name is Bob Dean. Thank you all very, very much.
Love you.